I now yield to the gentlewoman from New York, Ms. Hayworth.
Article 2, Section 1. The executive power shall be vested in a president of the United States of America. He shall hold his office during a term of 4 years, and together with the vice president, chosen for the same term, be elected as follows.
I now yield to the gentleman from New Jersey, Mr. Payne.
Each state shall appoint in such manner as the legislature therefore may direct a number of electors equal to the whole number of senators and representatives to which the state may be entitled in the Congress, but no senator or representative or person holding an office of trust or profit under the United States shall be appointed an elector.
I now yield to the gentleman from Indiana, Mr. Young.
The Congress may determine the time of choosing the electors and the day on which they shall give their votes, which day shall be the same throughout the United States.
I now yield to the gentleman from New Jersey, Mr. Pallone.
No person except a natural-born citizen or a citizen of the United States at the time of the adoption of this Constitution shall be eligible to be the office of president. Neither shall...
The chair would remind persons in the gallery, the chair would remind all persons in the gallery that they are here as guests of the House, and that any manifestation of approval or disapproval of the proceedings is a violation of the rules of the House. The chair notes a disturbance in the gallery in contravention of the law and rules of the House. The sergeant at arms will remove those persons responsible for the disturbance and restore order in the gallery. Gentleman from Virginia. Gentleman from New Jersey.
Neither shall any person be eligible to that office who shall not have attained to the age of 35 years and been 14 years a resident within the United States.
I now yield to the gentleman from Virginia, Mr. Griffith.
The president shall, at stated times, receive for his services a compensation which shall neither be increased nor diminished during the period for which he shall have been elected, and he shall not receive within that period any other emolument from the United States or any of them.
I now yield to the gentlewoman from California, Ms. Richardson.
Before he enter on the execution of his office, he shall take the following oath or affirmation. I do solemnly swear or affirm that I will faithfully execute the office of the President of the United States and will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States.
I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Latta.
Section 2. The President shall be Commander-in-Chief of the Army and Navy of the United States and of the militia of the several states when called in actual service of the United States. He may require the opinion in writing of the principal officer in each of the executive departments upon any subject relating to the duties of the respective offices, and he shall have the power to grant reprieves and pardons for offenses against the United States except in cases of impeachment.
I now yield to the gentleman from Virginia, Mr. Connolly.
He He shall have power by and with the advice and consent of the Senate to make treaties provided 2/3 of the senators present concur. And he shall nominate and by and with the advice and consent of the Senate shall appoint ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, judges of the Supreme Court, and all other officers of the United States whose appointments are not herein otherwise provided for and which shall be established by law.
I now yield to the gentleman from Louisiana, Mr. Cassidy.
But the Congress may by law vest the appointment of such inferior officers as they think proper in the President alone, in the courts of law, or in the heads of departments.
I now yield to the gentlewoman from Colorado, Ms. DeGette.
The President shall have power to fill up all vacancies that may happen during the recess of the Senate by granting commissions which shall expire at the end of the next session.
I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Johnson.
Section 3, he shall from time to time give the Congress information of the State of the Union and recommend to their consideration such measures as he shall judge necessary and expedient. He may, on extraordinary occasions, convene both houses or either of them, and in case of disagreement, between them.
I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Kucinich.
With respect to the time of adjournment, he may adjourn them to such time as he shall think proper. He shall receive ambassadors and other public ministers. He shall take care that the laws be faithfully executed and shall commission all the officers of the United States.
Thank you. I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Shabbat.
The President, Vice President, and all civil officers of the United States shall be removed from office on impeachment for and conviction of treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors.
I now yield to the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Smith, the Chairman of the Judiciary Committee.
The judicial power of the United States shall be vested in one Supreme Court and in such inferior courts as the Congress may from time to time ordain and establish. The judges, both of the Supreme and inferior courts, shall hold their offices during good behavior and shall at stated times receive for their services a compensation which shall not be diminished during their continuance in office.
I now yield to the gentleman from Georgia, Mr. Bishop.
Section 2. The judicial power shall extend to all cases in law and equity arising under this Constitution, the laws of the United States, and treaties made, or which shall be made under their authority, to all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers, and consuls, to all cases of admiralty and maritime jurisdiction.
I now yield to the gentleman from Texas, Mr. Farenthold.
To controversies to which these United States shall be a party, to controversies between two or more states, between the citizens of different states, between the citizens of the same state claiming lands under grants of different states, and between a state or the citizens thereof and foreign states and citizens or subjects.
Now yield to the gentleman from Indiana, Mr. Donnelly.
In all cases affecting ambassadors, other public ministers and consuls, and those in which a state shall be party, the Supreme Court shall have original jurisdiction. In all the other cases before mentioned, the Supreme Court shall have appellate jurisdiction, both as to law and fact, with such exceptions and under such regulations as the Congress shall make.
I now yield to the gentleman from New Mexico, Mr. Pierce.
The trial of all crimes, except in cases of impeachment, shall be by jury, and such trial shall be held in the state where the said crimes shall have been committed, but not when committed within any state. The trial shall be at such place or places as the Congress may by law have directed.
I now yield to the gentleman from Pennsylvania, Mr. Altmaier.
Treason against the United States shall consist only in levying war against them or in adhering to their enemies, giving them aid and comfort. No person shall be convicted of treason unless on the testimony of two witnesses to the same overt act or on confession in an open court.
I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Turner.
The Congress shall have the power to declare the punishment of treason, but to no attainder of treason shall work corruption of blood or forfeiture, except during the life of the person attained.
I now yield to the gentleman from Delaware, Mr. Carney.
Article 4, Section 1. Full faith and credit shall be given in each state to the public acts, records, and judicial proceedings of every other state. And the Congress may by general laws prescribe the manner in which such acts, records, and proceedings shall be proved, and the effect thereof.
I now yield to the gentleman from Maryland, Mr. Harris.
Section 2. The citizens of each state shall be entitled to all privileges and immunities of citizens in the several states.
Now yield to the gentleman from California, Mr. Schiff.
A person charged in any state with treason, felony, or other crime, who shall flee from justice and be found in another state, shall on demand of the executive authority of the state from which he fled be delivered up to be removed to the state having jurisdiction of the crime.
I now yield to the gentleman from Ohio, Mr. Gibbs.
Section 3. New states may be admitted by the Congress into this Union, but no new state shall be formed or erected within the jurisdiction of any other state, nor any state be formed by the junction of the two or more states, or parts of states, without the consent of the legislatures of the states concerned as well as for the Congress.
Now I yield to the gentleman from New York, Mr. Nadler.
The Congress shall have power to dispose of and make all needful rules and regulations respecting the territory or other property belonging to the United States. And nothing in this Constitution shall be so construed as to prejudice any claims of the United States or of any particular state.
I now yield to the gentleman from Nebraska, Mr. Fortenberry.
Or by conventions in three-fourths thereof, as the one or the other mode of ratification may be proposed by the Congress, provided that no amendment which may be made prior to the year 1808 shall in any manner affect the first and fourth clauses in the ninth section of the first article, and that no state, without its consent, shall be deprived of its equal suffrage in the Senate.
I now yield to the gentlewoman from California, Ms. Matsui.
Article 6. All debts contracted and engagements entered into before the adoption of this Constitution shall be as valid against the United States under this Constitution as under the Confederation.
I now yield to the gentleman from New Jersey, Mr. Garrett.
This Constitution and the laws of the United States, which shall be made in pursuance thereof, and all the treaties made, or which shall be made under the authority of the United States, shall be the supreme law of the land, and the judges in every state shall be bound thereby, any things in the Constitution or laws of any state to the contrary notwithstanding.
I now yield to the gentleman from Oregon, Mr. Blumenauer.
The senators and representatives before mentioned, and the members of the several state legislatures, and all executive and judicial officers, both of the United States and of the several states, shall be bound by oath or affirmation to support this Constitution, but no religious test shall ever be required as a qualification to any office or public trust under the United States.
Now I yield to the gentleman from Colorado, Mr. Lamborn.
The ratification of the conventions of nine states shall be sufficient for the establishment of this Constitution between the states, so ratifying the same.
I now yield to the gentlewoman from Hawaii, Ms. Hirono.
The word the being interlined between the seventh and eighth lines of the first page, the word 30 being partly written on an erasure in the 15th line of the first page, the words is tried being interlined between the 32nd and 33rd lines of the first page, and the word the being interlined between the 43rd and the 44th lines of the second page.
I now yield to the gentleman from Colorado, Mr. Tipton.
Dunning Convention, by unanimous consent of the states, present the 17th day of September in the year of our Lord, 1787. And of the independence of the United States of America, the 12th in witness whereof we have hereunto subscribed our names.
I now recognize the gentleman from Missouri, Mr. Carnahan.
Signers of the Constitution, George Washington, President and Deputy from Virginia, Delaware, George Reed, Gunning Bedford, John Dickinson, Richard Bassett, Jacob Broom, Maryland, James McHenry, Daniel of St. Thomas Jennifer, Daniel Carroll, Virginia, John Blair, James Madison, Jr.
I now yield to the gentleman from California, Mr. McClintock.
From the state of North Carolina, William Blount, Richard Dobbs Spate, Hugh Williamson. From South Carolina, John Rutledge, Charles Coatsworth Pinckney, Charles Pinckney, Pierce Butler. From Georgia, William Few, Abraham Baldwin.
Now yield to the gentleman from Washington, Mr. McDermott.
New Hampshire, John Langdon, Nicholas Gilman, Massachusetts, Nathaniel Gorham, Rufus King, Connecticut, William Samuel Johnson, Roger Sherman, New York, Alexander Hamilton.
Now I yield to the gentleman from Kansas, Mr. Yoder.
From New Jersey, William Livingston, David Brerley, William Patterson, Jonathan Dayton. From Pennsylvania, Benjamin Franklin, Thomas Mifflin, Robert Morris, George Clymer, Thomas Fitzsimmons, Jared Ingersoll, James Wilson, and Governor Morse.
I now yield to the gentleman from Michigan, Mr. Levin.
The preamble to the Bill of Rights. Congress of the United States, begun and held at the City of New York on Wednesday, the 4th of March, 1789.